Hello, this is Matt on the Moon Lambo channel. Ripple CEO Brad Garlinghouse says that the United States government, which done messed up by printing a whole bunch of money, he says that's going to be good for XRP and crypto in general. How about that? And I could not agree more. I've talked about this concept in the past, and I'm going to share with you with specifically, word for word, what Brad Garlinghouse had to say. So where did it all stem from? It was on this topic. I pulled up this piece from MarketWatch.com titled, "Fed Adopts New Strategy to Allow Higher Inflation and Welcome Strong Labor Markets." And so I've talked about how I'm skeptical, I still am, even after this, of the idea of near-term hyperinflation, but the idea of inflation that's perhaps a little bit higher than the typical plus or minus 2% annually. I've been saying I will not be the least bit surprised if it is, even in the coming years, higher than that on an annual basis. And now you get this headline, strategy to allow for higher inflation. Now it seems pretty much all but certain, and Brad Garlinghouse chimed in on this topic. So lots to cover in this video. But before we go any further, if you would please delicately tap that like button, I'd definitely appreciate it. And if you do, basically all it's going to do is tell the YouTube algorithm to go ahead and push this content, suggest this content to other people on the YouTubes. And also go ahead and subscribe to the Moon Lambo channel, because if you do, you will find true happiness. That's a Moon Lambo promise. Guaranteed are your money back. Which is fine, because this is free content, so there we go. All right, so here's the tweet from Brad Garlinghouse, and he wrote the following. "The pandemic is throwing so many playbooks out the window. Yesterday's action flies in the face of decades of precedent. Signs point to further dollar debasement in the near term, leading to further diversification of assets, which will certainly be good for crypto." Exactly. And so this is a system that is in the system we have today. It is set up so that those individuals that hold cash will become poor. And who's more likely to hold cash rather than assets? It's the poor. And by the way, I'm not trying to make some sort of case of the poor get poorer, the rich get richer. I think that's too unsophisticated, because there is upward mobility. I'm just trying to make the point that those people that are among the poorest, that just hang on to cash rather than investing in assets, whether it's gold or silver or stocks or crypto, you name it, real estate, whatever. Those people are going to be losing substantial value, even if they have the same balance in a checking account, because your dollars lose purchasing power thanks to inflation. Whereas the people that do the opposite and hold as little cash as possible and invest in things like cryptocurrencies and real estate and gold and stock, well, there you go. Those are the people that end up really generating substantial wealth. So it's not so hard. It's just like own assets and spend less than you make. You know, like just doing those two things, you're probably going to be fine over a span of decades. You're probably going to make it, okay? You are not, even if you're a poor person, you are not stuck to the lower class forever. Upward mobility is a real thing. Just be smart. Make smart decisions. You know, get advice from a financial advisor, which I am not, by the way. I don't have a financial background. I'm not offering advice. I'm just sharing with you my opinion. So don't buy or sell because of me, anything. But to me, it just seems like an undeniable fact of life here. And so what's ultimately happening with all of this? Well, you're seeing that money's flowing into the stock markets. That's why you see, like, the stock market, can we call it a bubble yet? It's like it's so overvalued. I don't know if it literally meets the definition of bubble. Like, I would think yes. I don't know. But crypto, on the flip side, to me, is not in a bubble. It's deflated. We're not that far from the local lows that we've seen, frankly, with any crypto, whether it's XRP, Bitcoin, whatever. And I understand how low Bitcoin got, and that it's almost at $12,000 as I record this. I got that. I'm just saying, in particular for like altcoins like XRP, though, fine, we're up 150% compared to a few months ago, but that still puts us at 27 cents, and the all-time high was closer to $4 here. But money has been flowing in. And so what's going on here? Well, take a look at this piece now, again, from MarketWatch. And by the way, Brad Garlinghouse, he He linked to the Wall Street Journal, which, my gosh, leads to a paywall. So I didn't pull that up for this particular video. Coil, I need you. I love you, Coil. Please find tremendous success using your blend of Interledger Protocol and XRP to make paywalls obsolete. Now, I know some people are going to, business models will require paywalls, and that's fine, but this third monetary option, for those of you that don't know Coil, my gosh, it's a new form of web monetization that streams money in real time, so you don't have to see advertisements and you don't get hit with paywalls for businesses that are adopting the technology. It's online today, and XRP is used for settlement in that real-world utility. How about that? But the Market Watch piece, let's jump in. The Federal Open Market Committee on Thursday announced that it has approved significant changes to its written policy strategy that are widely seen as leading to an easier monetary policy stance over time. In a new policy framework agreed to by all 17 top Fed officials, the central bank said it would allow inflation to run above 2% for some period of time. This is known as an average inflation target. The committee seeks to achieve inflation that averages 2% over time and therefore judges that, following periods when inflation has been running persistently below 2%, appropriate monetary policy will likely aim to achieve inflation moderately above 2% for some time, the new policy framework said. And so there you go. Keep in mind, when they're saying something like that, they're literally saying the system is designed to make the dollars that you have in your checking account worth less year over year, every single year in perpetuity. That is a design of the system, right? Just be aware of that. And so holding on to dollars, not such a good idea. Great to have a rainy day fund, all that. I understand it. But my gosh, it just makes sense to hold scarce assets. To me, that makes sense. Like XRP, for example. Now, the Fed also removed its bias against strong labor markets. The announcement of the new strategy was timed for Fed Chairman Jerome Powell's speech to the annual Jackson Hole Economic Symposium, to be held virtually this year. Fed chairmen have used the conference to make major policy announcements in the past. Now, some Fed watchers were surprised that the strategy was announced, as it looked like the Fed needed to more work on the plan, given how little it was mentioned in the minutes of the central bank's late July meeting. And in his speech, Powell trumpeted the changes, saying, quote, "A robust job market can be sustained without causing an outbreak in inflation." Economic evidence shows that minority communities benefit the most when strong labor markets persist. Support for strong labor markets would not have come from a central banker a generation ago. In the past, and this is where we're getting to precedent, right? Strong labor markets for the Fed officials meant that higher inflation was just around the corner and a reason to tap the brakes and raise interest rates, even if there was no sign of higher prices. Powell did not elaborate on what moderately above 2% means. Later on Thursday, Dallas Fed President Robert Kaplan said it meant inflation in a range of 2.25% to 2.5% annual rate. St. Louis Fed President James Bullard said the details needed to be avoided to achieve consensus. So we'll see. So maybe it's not set in stone, but, that's why, again, so I don't want to sound like I really do not believe that hyperinflation is likely to come. I guess it could. I'm not convinced that it's going to anytime soon anyway, not in the coming years. But this is still meaningful, which means that the dollars year over year, they're going to become worth less money even faster. Hooray! I am so happy that I am just putting any dollar that doesn't have to actually be used to pay bills or whatever. I'm taking everything else and I'm not buying nonsense crap I don't need with it. I'm just throwing it into assets. That's what I'm doing. And happy to put it in XRP. I mean, the markets are so illiquid with XRP relative to other asset classes. That's the reason you get this crazy multiplier effect. It's just insane, you know? And that's crypto. It's like, that's pretty well known. It's just, I think there are reasons that many people are afraid to invest in crypto. And I'm not pretending like there's no risk. Like, in fact, I would say investing in XRP or any crypto is very high risk, high risk. Even so, that doesn't, and again, that I always say this too, when I say something like that, that doesn't speak to my confidence. I'm highly confident. I just bought a crazy amount of XRP today. I really did. And it's still highly risky though. But still, like, I'm all about investing in scarce assets that are actually useful to the world, which should result in tremendous staying power. Like, to me, that makes a ton of sense. So take that for what it's worth, though. I'm just saying, like, inflation is going to be worse than it normally is, pretty much starting practically immediately. And I'm going to let it impact me as little as possible here. I'm just saying. It's like, I'm aware of this stuff, and it absolutely just it just reaffirms what I already believed, which is put money in assets, things that will appreciate. Don't keep it in cash, right? That's not a good thing to do. But that is it for this video. I am not a financial advisor. Do not buy or sell anything because of anything that I say or write. That would be a very, very, very bad idea. Until next time, to the moon, Lambeau.